we're going to have the time of 60 seconds, the amplitude of low, we're going to have the frequency at 50. So first of all, we're going to straddle the machine and do a quad recovery massage. So for me, it's an easy issue to remove the hand straps out of the way of the plate on the floor. I've already set the machine up ready to go. I have my VibroGym mat on top. So for me, it's easy to straddle, kneel down for my quad recovery, press my start, make sure my knees are off, make sure that my ribs are off. I can cross my feet over and rest them. I can relax the body. The pad is underneath me. I've got the top cushion on, so I can relax the body, relax the muscles, and just regular breathing. You can adjust the body if you're longer by moving the pad in and out. Again, you can have a towel here. Again, we're not stretching, we're massaging. I want to do a buttock gluteal massage. Press the start again. I can take myself back and just rest my feet on the floor. I'm doing the gluteal, my rib cage is off of the machine. I can even take myself back with my hands on my ribs. I'm completely relaxed and stable. My feet are flat on the floor. My knees are in line. I'm in the center of the machine. So this is my gluteus maximus. My coccyx is not immediately directly on. Again, I'm supported by the cushion. My body is centered up. I'm relaxed. I could have a towel or a small cushion under my head if this was really uncomfortable. The more athletic you are, you could bring yourself up and more active by resting onto the cushions. Powerhouse is in neutral here. Again, my rib cage is off of the machine. It starts to bleed down for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. I can transition from this movement here if I wanted to do a complete massage one. If I wanted then to work and release and massage my hamstring, press the start button again, move the body back, my kneecaps are rested, I can roll my body back or bring my leg in to roll back. Again, I have my entire hamstring on the platform itself. My coccyx is off, my rib cage is off. I'm centralized, I'm neutralized, I'm comfortable. My hands can be on my ribs, can be on my hips, wherever comfortable. Again, I can have a pillow underneath my head if I didn't feel quite comfortable. I'm breathing normally. So this is my recovery massage. Again, you're going to hear the bleeping down in a second. So we haven't changed the time, the frequency, or the amplitude for the entire time of the recovery massage. So again, it's nice to do the back massage, which we're going to do next, in the beginning, after you've done your warm-up on the treadmill. So here we go. So the next exercise for massage recovery is going to be, so I could either bring my knee in, rock up and roll up, bring myself forward because I want my lower lumbar to be on. Press the start again, check the cushion. Bring my knee in, rock and roll back so I'm safe. My lower lumbar is on, my feet can be up. If I have very long legs, I can cross them over. Or for me, as I'm 5 foot nothing, make sure that the lower lumbar is on. The rib cage is off. I'm centered, I'm secure, I'm comfortable. I can have my hands across. I can have my hands up, my body is centered up again, I can have a towel underneath my head. So my lower lumbar is on. I don't have to necessarily in-bring or scoop or pelvic tilt. Naturally my body will sink in, and as the vibrations start to do their job, center thigh. So I'm going to move my platform on. I can press start again. I can take my legs on. I'm rested on again. I can lay down to do my massage on the side. I can put my head up or stay here or on my extended with a towel. So my feet can be on or off. My top leg is rested on. My powerhouse is engaged. Breathing in to breathe out. So I'm comfortable. So this is my outer thigh massage. If I wanted to here, I could turn over and do my quad stretch, quad massage here, or completely turn over to do the outer thigh. Massage here, or I can turn myself over. So there's many ways to move the cushions around onto the side again. So I can take myself relaxed here, I can relax the arm out, I can rest the head up. It all depends on any skeletal or muscular problems that you have. The whole of my outer thigh is actually on the pad. My leg can be rested. If that was really uncomfortable, of course I could take it off. But again, it's much easier just to lay on your side. The powerhouse is in neutral position, resting the head. So this is your outer thigh. We're going to transition into the inner recovering massage and into the calf massage. So went to the machine, so we have two more to do. So these are your recovery after you've had your workout. Nice controlled breathing. So I can help myself up here. I can undo my cushion. I can lay on. So I'm going to do the inner thigh massage. So for me or my client, I would lay this up. You can move the top cushion off. So once more, you can get yourself on. Press your start button if it's for you. I'm on my side. I've got my inner thigh. Once more, I can rest my body here. My pubic bone is not onto the platform. My foot is resting on. My foot is off. So I'm aiming at my inner thigh massage. My hand can be on top, or my hand can be on the other cushion, or my hand can be on the side. Make sure that you align the body up so you're nice and centered. So this is your inner thigh massage. Again, relax the upper body. 30 seconds to go here. You can do 45 seconds or 60 seconds as we have here, which is nice after your workout that you've had on the Vibro Gym. 15 seconds. So we could transition instead of spinning around to the other side. We could put our calves on and do our calf massage. So I can help myself up here. I can transition in as I'm there. I don't have any medical problems. It's easy for me to press the start and just sit up and be comfortable doing my calf. My knees are off of the platform. I'm not